Welcome to Tiny Radio Thoughts, your little program on this channel where I talk about music news, channel updates, and many other topics related to music. As a reminder, if you enjoy this video, don't forget to subscribe to the channel for more. Before we get started, I wanted to thank you for all the feedback on the first episode that was published last month. I'm glad you guys enjoy this sort of podcast format as much as I do. And I was really just excited to get to the new episode, and there's so much to talk about. So let's start with a small channel update. About less than 2 weeks ago, we were getting close to 250 subscribers, and now we're already closer to 260. So as always, thank you so much for joining me on this little adventure. Also, my review of Namie Amuro finally has reached over 30,000 views, which is a new record for the channel, and honestly, I can't quite believe it. It seems like yesterday, where I was getting a few dozen views and losing my mind about it, and now I have reviews that reach numbers that I never thought was possible for this channel, so thank you so much. So there is a lot of music news to talk about, and the first topic is about Panic! At the Disco new album, Pray for the Wicked. It will come out this June, and the album has 11 songs, and so far we got 2 songs revealed, F, A Silver Lining, and Say Amen, Saturday Night. And I gotta say, the 2 songs are pretty good, even though I think Say Amen is the one that I love the most, because it is a very typical Panic! At the Disco song, especially if, like me, you enjoyed the previous album, Death of a Bachelor, which is an album that when it came out, I wasn't completely sold on it, but it grew on me and I ended up loving the album quite a lot, so Say Amen really sounds like it's following the same musical path, which is really... I'm not complaining, honestly. If it's as good as the previous album, then we might have a really good album on our hands in June, so I'm really excited about it. The music video is pretty fun if you want to check it on YouTube. But the song, I've been listening to it on Spotify quite a lot, and it's very addictive and it's super fun, and it really has this passion that I love so much about Brendan when he sings. It's messy, but at the same time it's really well organized, and the structure of the song I think is really great. So there's this album to look forward to. Then we got the announcement that Glim Spanky will release a new single in May. It's called All of Us. It will have 2 editions, 1 CD only and 1 CD and DVD. The DVD will have the Bizarre Carnival tour that was filmed in Taipei, in Taiwan. And as for the CD and the tracklist, we got 3 songs. We will have All of Us, that is linked to a drama in Japan. And then there's another song called To the Music. And finally, the 3rd song is called The Flowers. Actually, The Flowers has been made available on YouTube. I will pull the link down below if you want to listen to it. And we also got the visuals for the single, and it looks great. I already pre-ordered the CD DVD on CD Japan. I just couldn't resist. I was like, this is gonna be great once again. Then if it disappoint me, so I know I think we're getting towards a new album as well, because we had 2 singles, about, let's say, 5 songs, so maybe around September, October, like last year with Bizarre Carnival, we might get a new album, which is always a great news, and I'm really excited about all those songs. Another very exciting news is that Superfly is finally making an official comeback in June as well, with a new single. The single is called Bloom, and it will have 4 songs on it and 3 different editions. So you will have 2 CDs, 2 CDs and DVD, and 2 CDs and Blu-ray. As for the tracklist, the single will have the song Bloom. That was a song that was used during a very special live back in November last year. It was basically, the theme of it was there was going to be with an orchestra. I had the chance to be able to watch it. It's an amazing live, honestly. It was so good to see her back on stage, because if you don't know, she had some throat problem for many months, so she kind of put her career on hold for about a year and a half. So just seeing her back on stage, singing so beautifully, really made me happy, and obviously this announcement is great. Then we got the song Fall, and this one will be used for a Japanese TV show as well. And then we got the song Unison, and this one actually was used last year during the 5th season of Dr. X Gekai Daemon Michiko, which is one of my favorite TV shows in Japan. I really recommend it, but if you don't know, Superfly has been providing theme songs for this TV show ever since it started back in 2012. And Unison, they released a short version on Spotify, but it's only for a Japanese audience, so you can't really listen to it outside of Japan, which is really a shame. But I'm really looking forward to the full version because it really sounds like an amazing ballad. Then of course they added the Force Orchestra version. This one, however, you can listen to it on Spotify, it's available everywhere. And it's a really good, it's a different touch on the original song. I really like it. Then the second CD of this album will be basically the live version of the concert, so nothing that new. And the DVD and Blu-ray will basically be the full concert as well. So far I have not pre-ordered the CD because I'm still thinking about which version I'm going to get. So we'll see, but I think I might go for the two CDs and DVD. Then another exciting comeback is Crystal K will be back with a new single and especially a new album in June as well. There are so many releases in June. I am so excited to get to this month. And we don't know the title of the album. We know that we'll have 10 songs, 4 we already know because they were released before. And there's a new song called Shiawasete that will be used for a Japanese TV show. I'm really excited about Crystal K. I don't know if you guys remember, but I reviewed her last album back in 2015, so yeah, that was a long time ago. And I wasn't too sold on this album because if I recall correctly, it sounded too much like a Christmas album to me, even though it had really good songs like obviously Revolution featuring Namie Amuro. But I'm really looking forward to this one. I love Crystal K. I really like her voice, and when you give her really good songs, she kills it every time, so looking forward to this one. There's been the news that Emily from Luby Sparks actually left the band. So if you don't remember, a few months ago I reviewed their debut album, which I thought was such a good indie rock Japanese album, and I really liked Emily's voice, so I'm a little bit sad that she's leaving. Apparently the reason is that she wants to find another job, so unfortunately that's it. And actually they already found someone to replace her, she's called Erica, and I'm looking forward to hearing her voice and see what she can bring to the band. Then about another release in June, it's about Wednesday Campanella. I hope I'm pronouncing it right. But I remember one of you actually recommended me their music, and I gotta say, I really liked their album Superman. And this new album, however, is going to be called Galapados. It's coming out on the 27th of June. And I listened to the song they put on Spotify. It sounds really good. I think I might have a really good time with it. I'm really excited to actually get to review it. And a little more interesting thing about this album is that one of the songs will have a featuring with a French band called, once again, I'm not sure how you pronounce it because I never heard of them. It's called Mudoid. Mudoid. And apparently the singer of the band is featured on one of the songs from this new album, so I'll definitely tell you what I feel about it when it's up. But I'm really looking forward to this one too. Then in some K-pop news, Tiffany Young, ex-Girl Generation member, has started a solo career, and recently she released her own version of Remember Me from the Pixar movie Coco, and I kinda like this song, but I'm not overly crazy about it, and I've seen the movie, I really love the movie, but I think I prefer the original version of Remember Me than the pop version of it, so I think I'm a bit cautious on this one. I hope she's going to provide us with other songs, etc. But I'm really looking forward to see what she can bring as a solo singer now that she's not part of SM Entertainment anymore. Also, a few weeks ago was released an acoustic release from Muna. So now, if you don't remember, over a year ago they released their debut album About You, and it was definitely one of the highlights of the year for me. It was such a beautiful album, and this release has three songs. So we have Crying on the Bathroom Floor, If You Love Me Now, and I Know a Place, all acoustic versions. And I gotta say, these versions are absolutely beautiful. It really adds so much to the original, and I definitely recommend it. It's on Spotify, so feel free to check it out. Another exciting release coming this summer is Dan Owen's debut album. It's called Stay Away With Me, and it will come out on the 17th of August this year. Now, I've been listening to his music for a little bit now, and I gotta say the song Hideaway is incredible. What he does is a bit more like blues music, and it's really, he has such a powerful voice, and I'm really looking forward to his debut album because it might be really one to look forward to. And finally, there's something I wanted to talk about, there's something I've been thinking about, and I was thinking about taking a break from listening to Mika Nakashima's music. Now, if you've been following the channel right from the start, you know that she has been, in her career, very disappointing to me, and I'm not sure if I want to continue reviewing her music because I feel like every time she releases something, I'm always saying the same thing over and over. Now, maybe you noticed on my channel there's only one Ayumi Yamasaki review, and that's because when I did this review back then, I was still listening to her music, but then I decided to stop. Because just like Mika, Ayu's music has been disappointing me for a while, and thing is, I stopped listening to her back at the end of 2015, and recently I got back to it. I got back to her music, I put all my old albums back in my music library, and it feels good actually. I'm glad I took this break because now I appreciate her older music, but also her most recent a little bit better. It really allowed me to take a good step back and remember that even some releases are disappointing to me, there's some that are still absolutely incredible. And I think I'm gonna do that with Mika Nakashima as well. I'm gonna stop listening to her, and I'm gonna take like a 2 years break, and then I slowly come back to it. So I don't know, I'm not sure if I will still review. I think I'm gonna take a break on reviewing her newest music as well, and maybe catch up later, but for now, yeah, I'm thinking that's the way to go. Because at this point, I feel like I said, I feel like I'm just repeating myself over and over. And her music is just not interesting to me anymore, if I have to be completely honest. The last time I was really, really enthusiastic and happy with what she was releasing was in 2013. So it's been 5 years now. And it's been very, very long 5 years, especially if you're a fan. And anyway, I won't talk more about that because I feel like I've already said a lot, but yeah, that's, I wanted to tell you that if you wonder why you don't see any reviews from her on my channel, that might be why. And now that I've talked about most of the music news I wanted to talk about, let's talk about the releases for this month of April that I'm really excited about. So first we got a new mini album from Twice coming on the 9th. It's called What Is Love. From the visuals, it looks like it's going to be very bubbly, very cute as usual. So I actually enjoyed their debut album quite a lot on Twistagram. So I'm going with this mini album with an open mind, and we'll see how it goes. Then we also got, I already talked about that last time, but we got Janelle Monáe new album, Dirty Computer. Obviously very excited about this one, I'm still listening to the two songs that have been released prior to the album quite a lot. Then we got a new single from Kana Nishino called I Love You. Looking forward to this one. I was very disappointed with her last album, but we'll see if she can climb back up. And finally, obviously, I've talked again last time about this, but there's Obukuro Nariaki's debut album. Obviously, I will review it, but I'm really looking forward to this one as well. And on this note, this is how I'm going to end this second episode of Tiny Radio Thoughts. Thank you for listening, and don't forget that you can ask me questions under this video, or even ask me to talk about all the topics for next episode in the comments section down below. As for me, I'll see you soon on the channel with more reviews, and next month for another episode.